Bismillah, the hijab. Is Islam the only religion that instructs women to wear a veil? Are there other religions or cultures that instruct their women to wear a veil? Do men have to wear a veil? And what's the wisdom behind it? Although the English word scarf and the Arabic term hijab have become interchangeable, it is worth noting that hijab is more than just a scarf. Hijab is a way of ensuring that the moral boundaries between unrelated men and women are respected. In this sense, the term hijab encompasses more than a scarf and more than a dress code. It is a term that denotes modest dressing along with modest behavior. A common misconception is that Muslim women are the only ones who cover their hair. It may be true that Muslims are the only group in which most women follow the directive to cover the hair, but this was the dress code of believing women, women who truly submitted to God's will, i.e. Muslims. Now let's look at Christianity. True followers of Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, dressed modestly, especially his mother Mary, may peace be upon her. Throughout the Bible, there is a reference to modest dress. For instance, the first epistle to the Corinthians, chapter 11, verses 3 through 10, read, "But every woman praying or prophesying with her head uncovered disgraces her head, for it is the same as if she were shaven. For if a woman is not covered, let her be shaven. But if it is a disgrace for a woman to have her hair cut off, or her head shaved, then let her cover her head." What about Judaism? The covering of women's hair is part of Jewish laws on modesty. A woman's hair is considered irvah, or erotic stimulus, which must therefore be covered, just as other irvah parts of a woman's body must also be covered. There are many references in the Old Testament that indicated that. Let's look at a couple. In Genesis 24:65, "So she took her veil and covered herself." In Genesis 38:14, "And she put her widow's garments off from her and covered her with a veil and wrapped herself." How about other religions? Here are some examples of women's head coverings by different religions. Now, how about the hijab in America? Part of early American culture, covering the hair was part of their rituals because early American generations were more religious and it was a part of modesty and dignity. This practice didn't go away until nakedness was introduced later in the 19th century. How about the elite? The first recorded instance of veiling for women is recorded in an Assyrian legal text from the 13th century BC, which restricted its use to noble women and forbade prostitutes and common women from adopting it. When Islam came, it came to continue the commands of God to all his prophets and restore the dignity of women, modesty, and equality. Now, is there hijab for men? Islam does not only require the veil for women, but it also requires that men too dress modestly. Some people usually only discuss hijab in the context of women. However, in the glorious Quran, Allah the Almighty first mentions hijab for men before hijab for the women. The Quran mentions in chapter Nur, "Say to the believing men that they should lower their gaze and guard their modesty. That will make for greater purity for them, and Allah is well acquainted with all that they do." So what's the wisdom behind the veil? The ultimate wisdom is that God has created us and God knows what's best for us. Hijab is a representation that the one who wears it is a Muslim. A sister who truly wears a veil should be a role model of morality, modesty, purity. She would not lie, cheat, and she is well behaved and you can trust her. The wisdom behind it is that it tells men out there that this woman has boundaries and she is not playing any games and she is definitely not a toy. If a woman presents herself as a sex object, men will treat her as a sex object. And if she presents herself as a respectable and honorable human being, people will view her as a respectable human being. Hijab is there to protect the honor of women and restore their dignity. A woman who has covered herself and dressed modestly is judged only by the content of her character and not based on society's view of the quote-unquote perfect body type. She is valued as an intellectual and individual rather than an object of carnal desire. In a recent study in America, men would view women in bikinis as objects. So the more immodest you are, the more you became an object in the eyes of men. This is not acceptable behavior by men who should lower their gazes and guard their own chastity. But these examples show the impact on society, whether right or wrong. Hijab also protects women from the burden society places on the body image. You see many women and even young girls starve themselves or go as far as to commit suicide over having an imperfect body. The amount of stress and pressure placed on women to look a certain way is not healthy or beneficial. To place impossible physical standards on women is unfair and damaging. Hijab solves this crisis. A woman's body figure is not exposed to be judged. She is valued as a human being. Hijab is the dress code of Mary, may peace be upon her, the Prophet's wives, and all honorable women. Islam came to make women as elites, not like sex objects. Islam came to restore the honor of the women and not to take it away from them. Islam came to protect women from the evils of society. And remember, if you have questions about Islam, ask a Muslim.